Ena pula pula o neia aina, o ka hume kula iwi mai hae hae āhiki i ka mole o le hua, velina mai kākou. As I prepare for this speech, one word consistently came to my mind, commitment. It is something I highly value as a young Hawaiian, and I believe that commitment is the key to success. The Honorable Thomas Ka'owai Kaulukukui Jr. exemplifies this. A 1963 graduate of Kamehameha Schools, Judge Kaulukukui received his Bachelor's of Science degree in education from Michigan State University in 1967, and through perseverance and commitment, received his law degree from the University of Hawaii William Richardson School of Law in 1977. His personal accomplishments as an attorney are many. Eventually being appointed trial judge to the First Circuit Court in Honolulu and serving as arbitration and land court and tax appeal judge. In 1993, Judge Kaulukukui would become the Vice President of Community Affairs for the Queens Health System, where he worked to improve community health throughout preventative health education, housing, youth leadership, and the Hawaiian Homes Commission. In 1998, Judge Kaulukukui was appointed as trustee to the Queen Liliuokalani Trust and currently serves as chair of the Board of Trustees. In spite of the demanding professional career, Judge Kaulukukui is also committed to serving his community as an instructor and mentor in several programs, including the Hawaii Center, Pauahi Leadership Institute, Aikido, and the Hawaiian Culture Practice of Lua. Judge Kaulukukui has been married for over 35 years to his wife, Joyce, have 3 children and 3 grandchildren. Judge Kaulukukui exemplifies commitment to family, community, education, and especially to the Lahui. My dream one day is to become a shoe designer, a little bit different from being a judge, but I know the same commitment our keynote speaker had to become he is today is the same kind of commitment I need to succeed. I stand before you and ask you, what is your dream? What is it going to take to make your dream come true? E'o umauhoa opio, e olu olu. Please welcome our keynote speaker this evening, the Honorable Judge Thomas Ka'owai Kaulukukui Jr. Mama.
Let's give the introducer a hand. Ano ai kakou, greetings to all. How many of you, ano ai kakou, greetings to all.
Aloha.
How many of you got up before 8 o'clock? Raise your hand. You got up before 8 o'clock. How many of you got up before 7 o'clock? Raise your hand. How many of you got up before 6 o'clock? Raise your hand. Oh, how many? Malui, lui, how many? Tired. Before 5 o'clock? Okay, put your hand down. How many of you never went to sleep last night? Ah, that's the one. Put your hand down. All right, let's start by waking everybody up. So everybody, do what I do. Okay, when I say pai, we're going to pai and clap and make one sound. All right, ready? Pai. Ooh, late over here, early over there. Pai. Better. A little still early over here. Pai! 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 All right, very good. When the last sound went into the air, we made one sound. All spirit, mind, body, all together. Okay, now I can teach because everybody's together. All right, from time to time, during this lesson, I might say, Tupa, at which point you go, Tupa! 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 All right, anytime I do this, you just do this. Okay. The guy next to you sleeping, you go like this. All right, ready? Pai! 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 Tupa! Ah! Tupa! Okay, good. All right. This is Ahakane. Ahakane. Ahakane means what? A gathering of? What?
Men.
Technically, it means a gathering of males. Kane means male of any species. So, what's the male pig called? Pua'a? Kane. Yeah. What's a male cow? Dobu. Pipi? Kane. Okay? So I'm going to get technical with you. The word for the male of any species that deposits the sperm, right, that fertilizes the egg is a kane. Right? It's a kane. Now, the title of my talk is a hokanaka. A hokanaka, becoming a man. So there must be a difference between kane and kanaka. Eh? This is from our Lelano Eau. Our ancestors, our elders told us, a hokanaka. Right? So this is what this talk is about. Okay. And part of why we're all together is to better understand ourselves and others and to learn to interact more effectively and to understand why and how we should become a man. Now, I know a lot of kane who are not kanaka. They are male, but I don't think they are men. What's the difference is the question. Well, let's explore that. Okay? Our ancestors told us, hokanaka, be, become, act like a man. I put the word in there. Act like a real man. Okay? There's another challenge. It says, hanaka ivi akanaka alaila hohoa mai. It's a lua challenge. Hey, grow your bones to manhood, then come challenge me. You still a boy. Right? Great challenge, yeah? So, male, I just told you that. Kane is a male. It means masculine, right? We know what a female is. Okay. So the question is, where does our sense of self, where does all of this come from, okay? Male versus male, man, okay? Now give me 1 second, because I gotta find the right one. Where's my computer expert? Oh, no need. Okay, we'll go back. All right, let's talk about kane and kanaka. All right. Why didn't our ancestors say a hokane, be a male? Well, you think about that, I'll tell you a story. I was asked to go to the Maui prison and talk to convicted felons. A felony is something, some of you may know what a felony is. I hope not. Felony is a crime for which you can be in prison for more than one year, right? For more than 1 year, right? So I go in there, 25 males, mostly Hawaiian. They're sitting like this in a chair, yeah? You can imagine. It was about this time. They tell me later, they schedule me in the TV hour. So instead of watching Desperate Housewives, they got to listen to me. So they're all like this in a chair. So I say, I talk about this, kane and kanaka. All right? So I asked this question of you. I told them, you know, from my study, kane, the male of every species, are primarily motivated by 3 things. Primary motivations of a kane, of a male. Remember, we're not talking kanaka, we're talking kane only. Well, they look at me like you're looking at me. I said, I give you a hint. They all start with F. Did I ask you to scream it out yet? No? You should be thinking in your mind. Somebody said female. Well, that's not the first F they yelled out. Okay? They yelled out another F, got 4 letters, start with F, end with K, got U and C in the middle. Okay? That's the first F came out. But you know, when I teach young people, I say female, nicer word, okay? So they yell out the first word, and I write it on the board. I said, I cannot write the word you just wrote on the board Because when a warden goes by and he looks at that word, he says, what is the judge teaching them? So I write F-A-R-K, FARC. Okay? One of the primary moves, or the primary motivations of every male animal is to FARC, mostly with females. It's the drive to have sex. If we didn't have it, we would not be here. You know how the dinosaurs extinct, yeah? You know what happened? Got down, the asteroid hit Earth. The great cloud came over, killed almost all the dinosaurs. Only had one male, one female dinosaur left. The male dinosaur said, we better make babies, otherwise it's gonna be extinct. The female dinosaur said, not tonight, dear, I have a headache. That's it. Extinction. Okay? Extinction. The male dinosaur tried to do his job, but extinction. That's what happened. So that's what they tell me first. They tell me, yell out the first F. All right, FARC. Okay, first F, male, drive, propagation of the species. Okay, what's the second F? Well, I gotta yell out. Well, by the way, I told them, you can get 100% on this test. This is a test. You can get A plus. Most of you didn't do that well on tests. You get A plus on this one. So they yelled out, second F. Okay. The guy said, beef! Remember what I told him? They all start with F. Yeah. He yelled out, beef! I said, you're not talking teriyaki. You're not talking sirloin tip. You're not talking beef ribs. What you mean is fight, yes? Fight. I said, the F came in the wrong place, but it's okay, I give you credit for that. Because the word is beef. Right? It's fight. That's the second F. Male of the species. What causes us to do that? Testosterone in us, the male hormone. It's the protection, it's the fight. Males fight for what? Dominance?
Women.
Females? Fun? Right? That's just males. Okay. That's the second F. Okay. What's the third F? Primary drive of food. Of course, the guy yelled out, rinds! Yeah? Rinds! Yeah? He meant food. He was right. They got them all right. So the primary drives, all starting with Fs, for carne, males, no matter what age, first F is what?
Fart.
Second F is?
Fight.
Third F is?
Grind.
Food, yeah. Food, or grinds, okay. All right, okay. So if those are the Fs and those are the drives, and if that's what that defines who we are as males, what's the difference between a kane and a kanaka? What's the difference between a kane and a kanaka? Is there a difference?
Yes.
Different words, huh?
Yes. Yeah?
Is there a difference? What's the difference?
Can be born with a kane.
Yeah, we all kane because we're born with it. Yeah? Flashlight, two batteries. That's Kyle Nakane Lua. I thank him for that. That's what Kyle says. Flashlight, two batteries. Some get mag light. Some get pen light. Some get mag light. Some get pen light. Some got D cells. Some got 9 volts. Some got triple A. Okay. No matter. No matter. Only thing that matters is if you're born with it and you have it, you know, and you don't change it, then you're male. So we all qualify as males. Everybody in here is male. But is everybody in here a man? So how we define manhood then? That's the question. How you define manhood? How do we get to manhood? We can all hold kane, right? We can act like males. Question is, how do we act like men?
Ben for his family.
What's that?
Ben for his family.
Okay, take care of your family, right? What else? What else? Well, here's what I told the told the young man who were in prison, and I'm telling it to you tonight because it turned out to be a lesson that was good for them. We got to change our Fs. Our Fs have to transform. Okay? Because the drive for males, for females, for sex with females has nothing in it that deals with responsibility. Right? You can be a carne, have sex, make babies, do all that stuff with females, right? But have nothing in there for responsibility. So the first F has to change. That FARC has to change to what?
Fatherhood.
Fatherhood. The first F, which is sex, female relationships without responsibility, has to change to fatherhood, which talks about caring for, respecting your partner, providing for your family, and taking care of the children you make. Easy to make, hard to take care of. Okay? Yeah? Pai! 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 Tupa! 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 All right, I'm not saying I'm so interesting that nobody falls asleep. It's just I have a way to wake them up, okay? Right there, okay? All right, what are we on? First F, change from? Okay, this is the Kane side of the stage. This is the Kanaka side of the stage. So the first F is what? Right, and to change to Kanaka, we gotta change that to?
Fatherhood.
First F gotta change from FARC to fatherhood. Now, our second F was what?
Fight.
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 Not beef. Okay, so the second F was?
Fight.
And that has to change to?
Defend.
It has to change to defense. We don't fight. We're not aggressor. We change to defend self. Only to defend family, defend community, defend nation. And that's one of the principal teachings of Lua. Lua is second strike. Only defense. The story is told of the two Lua masters on the big island. Right? Wanted to fight each other. Problem was, what's the problem?
Yeah,
who got to show first? Yeah, that was the problem. Maybe that's not a problem because then you don't have a fight.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you're not supposed to have a fight. Of course, one side solved that problem because his handler said to him, when he insulted you, he struck you with his tongue. That was the first blow. Okay, we're going now. Okay? Some way to work their way around that problem. Okay? So the second F is? Second F is? And to become a Kanaka, you have to change it to fend, as in defend. Defend, okay? Our third F was?
Food.
The third F was food, okay. Now, how do we change from male, food, which is incoming, to a Kanaka?
Feed.
That F changed to what?
Feed,
which is a verb. Now, food is a noun, incoming, self. How many males you know, huh? They feed food, they feed the desire for a bigger truck, they feed the desire for more women, they feed the desire for drugs, they feed the desire for alcohol, all incoming. That's all carne stuff. Okay. Kanaka is outgoing, which means you feed your family, you feed your community through service, you feed your nation through maybe military service, you go. It's outgoing, you're giving stuff. It's a verb, okay? That's a verb. So if you look at the three Fs, you look at, first one was FARC, okay? That has to change to fatherhood with responsibility. Fighting for fun, for status, for dominance, that has to change to being defensive. Defend yourself, right? And you should train so you know how to defend yourself, right? And then thirdly, the important thing is the food has to change into feeding, okay? Now, for most of us, when we're male and we want to be, we're kane and want to be kanaka, there is a gap. And the key is how you close the gap. It's not enough to know you go from here to Waianae. Question is how you get there, right? Okay, gap. How you spell gap? How you spell gap?
G-A-P.
G-A-P. It's not that hard, guys. You can do it. You can do it. Even late at night, you can do it. Okay? All right, gap. That's your path. Gap, G-A-P. G, the first G, ho-maku-a, you got to grow up. Grow up physically. Grow your bones to manhood. Grow up maturity, emotionally, spiritually. That's one step to get from this side to that side. It's the G in the word gap. The A is you got to accept responsibility as kuleana. All this is about, most of this is about accepting responsibility, which is kuleana. Right? And the P is you got to practice. You got to ho'oma'ama. So for those of us who are training young people, we have to give them opportunities to practice. To practice feeding, for example, doing service. Okay? To practice being defensive and not offensive. Got to curb that aggressiveness. Okay? And we got to practice with our relationships with others. Right? All right. We use this in Queen Liliuokalani Trust as a basis for our boys' groups, this whole Kanaka lesson. Simple lesson, easy to remember, and every time somebody starts doing something that they shouldn't be doing, real simple. Eh, bro, eho kanaka. Act like a real man. Eho kanaka. Easy way to remind each other to do this. Yeah? Okay, any questions on this? Because I don't want to talk too long because it's late, but I do want to do something after this that's kind of, yeah, I need a, okay, I'll use you before. Come. I'll finish your activity. Nobody falls asleep when there's a fist in his face. So I'm gonna split you up in pairs in just a second, okay? Okay, come. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do this drill. Fist. Okay, first thing you gotta do is we're gonna measure. One fist width. His job when he punches is not to move his shoulder. If you move his shoulder, he's gonna ruin my dental stuff. All right, I'm going to start you off, and then we're going to break you up into groups of two. One. One. Everybody say one.
One.
One. I count, you count. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
One.
One.
Left hand.
Oh, left hand. Oh, one.
One. Two.
Two.
Three.
Three. Open. Four.
Four.
Okay, you're a partner. Stand up. About same height. Yeah, you can go. But you gotta sit. Bring your partner up here so you can come. All right, quickly, quickly, get a partner. If you don't have a partner, raise your hand. Okay, one there, one there. Oh, right there. Okay. Spread out a little bit. All right, everybody, give me your attention. Turn, face me. One of your group is number one. Raise your hand, number one. Number one, raise your hand. Put your hand down. The other one, number two. Number two, raise your hand. Okay, you only need to remember two numbers. Okay. All right, number two. Put your fist out, vertical fist like this. Make your shoulders square. Thumb on top. Measure. One chin width. There you go. All right, both of you move your left foot slightly forward. Left foot slightly forward. Keep your distance. Okay, number two, leave your hand there. Okay, number one, put your hand down. Okay, no, number two, leave your hand there. Okay, number one, with your left hand, palm facing towards your right ear, brush that wrist to your right ear. Only to your right ear. Don't hit it in the neck zip code. Once it goes past your right ear, not going to hit you. You hit it in the exact zip code, it's going to go around the block, come back and hit you someplace else. Okay, number two, put your hand up again. When I say one, you will count one, number one, and you will block one. Ready? One.
One.
Now everybody got to count. Put your hand back down. Ready? One.
One.
Again. Ready? One.
One.
Ready? One.
One.
Okay, everybody put their hand down. Number one, put your fist up. Vertical fist. Measure. Measure the right distance. Put your left foot slightly forward, both of you. Okay, drop your hand down. Except for number one, fist still up. Okay. Number two, you're going to block with your left hand. Palm up, cross to the opposite ear. One. Do it.
One.
Drop your arms. Drop your hand. Again, one.
One.
Only to the opposite ear. Again, drop your hand. One.
One.
Everybody got to count. One.
One.
Drop your hand. One.
One.
Drop your hand. One.
One.
Okay, drop your hand. Give me your attention. Where's my partner? Come, quick. One. You count. I count. You count. One.
One.
Okay, number two. Right hand, go outside. Scrape the hair off his arm. Cover your ear. Okay, watch again. Scrape the hair off your arm. Cover your ear. Other hand, go to the elbow. Go this way so you can see. Two. One. Two.
Two.
Okay, watch. Be nice to your partner. Just scrape the hair off like this. Okay? This could be this. It could be this. But it's not, because we're nice. Okay? Because we change our first, second F from fight to defend. Okay, so one.
One.
Two.
Two.
Okay, go ahead. All right, number two, put your fist up. Number two, fist up. Make it a vertical fist, your thumb on top. Measure. Stay with me. One.
One.
No good, everybody got to count. It's your left hand you're blocking with. One.
One.
Okay, two.
Two.
Okay, stay there, freeze. Right hand cover your right ear. Left hand in your elbow. Left hand touch your elbow. There you go. All right, drop your hands. Ready again. One.
One.
Left hand block. There you go. Two.
Two.
Scrape the hair off the arm. Scrape the hair off the arm. Drop your arms again. Ready. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Again.
One.
One. Punch right hand. Right hand punch. No. Yeah, right hand. Two.
Two.
All right, number one, put your fist up. Ready, one.
One.
Everybody got to count. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
One is left hand block now. Left hand block on one. Ready. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Cover your ear. Ready. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Good. Okay, hop out. Face me. Give me your attention. Only have four movements. The count's going to end up, though. 12, 34, okay?
Oh, fark.
One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Okay, again. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
The hand is on the elbow, gonna block this across his body. Three.
Three.
Leave the other hand here. Okay, one more time, go this way. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Okay. Okay, number two, put your fist up. All right, everybody count. Right fist, right fist, right fist, right fist. There you go. Ready. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three. Press that elbow. Elbow, elbow, elbow. Watch, watch. Give me eyes. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Press the wrist instead. Three.
Three.
See, you press wrist instead of elbow. My elbow free. You gotta press elbow, not wrist. Okay, go ahead. He's gonna eat his elbow if you don't press his elbow. I told him to do it, yeah, I told him to. All right, ready? Number two, put your fist up. Number two, one. Everybody count. Two. Three. Yeah, elbow down and across. Recover. Ready? One. Two. Three. Down and across. Ready? One. Two. Three. All right, Huli. Number one, put your fist up. Ready? One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three. Press the elbow with your palm down and across. Ready? One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Good. What were you pressing on?
Elbow.
Elbow, not the wrist. Elbow. Ready? One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Hop out. Give me eyes. Come. All right, number four, last movement. One,
one,
two,
two,
three.
Three.
Don't block. Four.
Four.
Yeah. Don't block. One,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four.
Four.
Okay. Number two, put your fist up. Number two, put your fist up. All right, number one, when he punches the last one, don't block, just let it come out. One,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four.
Four.
Good. Again, one,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four.
Four.
Again, one,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four.
Four.
Okay, Huli, number one, put your fist up. All right, ready? One,
one.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
And a hole. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Okay, hop out. Nana. Watch. Here's the count. Listen. 12, that's the count. 12 is made up of what?
1 and 2.
1 and 2. 12,
one.
3, 4. Okay, watch. 12,
12.
3, 4. Yeah. 12, she's on bounce. Listen to the sound. Yeah. 12, 3, 4. Okay, get ready. Okay, number two, put your fist up. When I count 12, you count 12. It is 1 and 2 together. Ready? 12, 3, 4. Recover. 12. Three. Four. Recover. 12. 1, 2. Three. Four. Huli. Number one, put your fist up. Hey, hold on, hey, listen. 12. Good. Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Good. Okay, I know. Recover. 12.
Three.
Four.
Four.
I know. 12. Three.
Four.
Okay, Nana, give me eyes. What do you think the next count is?
123.
First one is 12. What's the next one? 34. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, count with me. 12. 34.
34.
Back together. This is the sound is this. Listen now, listen. Listen. That's the sound. If I hit him, the two sound make sound same time. Okay? Count with me. 12. 34.
34.
Okay, go ahead. Get ready. All right, ready? 12.
12.
Ah, no good. Drop your hand, recover. You gotta count. The reason you have to count is for those of you who teach, if you wanna teach this, you gotta have the count in your head. All ready? 12.
12.
34.
34.
Okay, on the hole, ready? 12.
12.
34.
34.
Remember, the sound on the arm will be the sound of the fist. And again, ready? 12.
34.
All right, Huli, number one, put your fist up. Measure. Some of you guys in different zip codes. If you're in different zip code, no need block. Okay, ready? 12. 34. Ready? 12. 34. All right, ready? 12. 34. Okay, now, watch. Okay, watch. All right, here's the last drill. Listen carefully. This drill you do slow motion. Everybody repeat after me. Slow motion.
Slow motion.
Slow motion.
Slow motion.
Okay. Slowly. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four. My one.
Oh, okay.
My one. We're gonna go like this. Make real smooth, nice round. Block, block. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three, three, four. One, two, three.
Off.
Yeah, it looked easy, but not easy. Okay, go with your partner. Slow motion. One, one, two, three, block. Go slow, 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 slow. Go slow. Two, Bart, two, three, there, yeah, fuego. Okay, hopo, everybody up. Come up, sit down. Come up. Okay, the exercise, hand-eye coordination exercise. Just good hand-eye coordination exercise. Okay, can be fighting exercise, but we're just doing it for the hand-eye. Okay, and so, you can practice it throughout the rest of the Akane. And when you do it without the intent of beating up your partner, because as soon as you do that, it just proves that you're still a and not a. That's right. See the difference? You have the right attitude, the right spirit of teaching. You're actually feeding, because you're giving yourself to help your partner learn. That attitude is Kanaka attitude. Huh? I look at the young people, they want to punch each other, ooh, and then make that kind of all kinds of fancy stuff. Dead giveaway, kane, 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 stuff. Okay? Haven't control yet, no more self-control. Okay? Haven't grown up yet, haven't accepted responsibility, okay? And they're not practicing the right things. Okay, so we're going to finish with a review. Okay, this lesson was about a whole Kanaka, eh? Yeah? So we'll go back to that, to the first one. Whole Kanaka, and we talk about how to transition from the maleness, which we all have and which we all are, to the Kanaka. That's why I tell you it has nothing to do with chronological age. I know people my age, they're still acting like Kane. They haven't got it yet. And what I told those prisoners is, I can come back here year after year, and if you still feeding your Kane urges, I'm going to see you here still. You're never going to get out of here because society requires at some point that you mature and become a Kanaka. We need a community of Kanakas. This is called an ahakane because you're not required to be a Kanaka to be here. All you need to be here is to have what? Flashlight, two batteries. That's all you need to be here. That's all, okay? If this was an ahakanaka, and they had a way to test it, some of us would not be here. Or not, maybe not nobody here, of course, but some of us might not qualify to be here. So you gotta understand. So I'm gonna finish with that review. All right, three primary drives of a male of any species of Akane, they all start with F. What's the first one I told you?
Fire.
Which deals with females and sex. Second one was?
Fire.
Fight for dominance. For females, for your ego, sometimes just for fun. Okay? And the third F for Kane was food, which is incoming. Feed your own habit, feed the stuff you want, you don't care about anybody else. Okay? There is a gap, let's pass the gap for now. And in order to be a Kanaka, you have to change your Fs. And the first F, which is FARC, has to change to
fatherhood,
sexual responsibility. And the second F, which was has to be defend or defend your family, not the aggressor. And the third F, which was
food
is
feed.
It's the verb which means you have to feed your family. And we're not only talking about food, we're talking about feeding through service and through good acts for your community as well as your family, and maybe for your nation. You may have to feed your life for your nation, give your life for your nation, all right? And I said there's a gap between the two. And we spell gap? G-A-P. And the path is not that hard. You just gotta grow up, accept responsibility, that's kuleana, and practice it. You gotta practice. What we did tonight, you know, with this self-defense exercise, we're actually practicing Kanaka stuff. Because I look out there, I say, okay, there's a couple Kane over there, a whole bunch of Kane over there trying to kill each other over there. Guy over here having a good time over there. Look, they're doing the front kicks now because I'm not teaching that, but you know, because they want to dominate their opponent. Hey, I could do this to you, you know. Yeah, there's the test right there. Maybe we ought to give this test before you can come in and register. There you go. You out, you go home, you go home. Hey, you can come in. Yeah. All right, anybody have any questions? One more time just to see whether we're on the same wavelength over here. All right, ready? Pai! Come on, get together here. Pai! Not bad. Pai! Tupa! Ah, see, you lost.
Tupa!
Tupa! Tupa! Tupa! All right, it's been a long day. I want to thank you all for your attention. Some of you got up really early and some of you came very far. It's a privilege for me to spend time with you, to share some of the thoughts that I have, and some of the teachings that I have. I'm trying to fulfill my responsibility as a Kanaka to feed you some information that might be of some help to you. I ask that you can enjoy yourself, be safe through the rest of the weekend. I hope that the things that are taught to you here, or that you may learn or pick up, not just from me, but from others, you can take back and will help you in your families and in your communities. I ask that you go back and take care of your land, the sands of your birth from wherever you came from, and may you all be loved, honored, cherished, and protected by He who dwells in the heavens and He whose spirit is everywhere, all right? He who is greater than us all. Aloha.